See that screen. Right. So yesterday we had seen that there are some characteristics of your D block elements we have seen. Why D block elements and our complex compounds formation is takes place, and what is why D block elements and all colored ions they are exhibiting. So that and all yesterday class we have seen that. And today what you are going to see means, so D block elements, what are the catalytic properties and formation of interstitial compounds and alloys formation and some more concepts, important compounds of transition elements. Some important compounds of transition elements. So these things and today we are going to learning about that. So first of all, if you are see that why D block elements and all acting like catalytic properties, how they're acting like catalyst means. So mostly all the D block elements and all they're acting like a catalytic property, they are behaving is takes place. Why they're behaving here catalytic properties means due to presence of your variable oxidation states, and more number of your unpaired electrons is presenting there, right? So especially unpaired electrons like that, that word and all you are sequentially are using in this D block elements and all especially. Why they are forming colored ions, why they are exhibiting interstitial compound, why they are exhibiting here catalytic property, why they are forming Li formation. So all these cases, mostly what you are using mean, common word you are using that, mostly elements are containing here, unpaired electrons is presenting there. So that word and all commonly we are using in this topic, especially for that. So let us see that. Why D block elements, which elements are especially they're acting like catalyst means. So most of the elements are they behaving like catalytic, a catalyst like that, they behaving is takes place. So for example, see that if you are taking that Haber process, you are taken Haber's process. So in that Haber's process, what is the catalyst we are using means iron oxide or iron. So iron is acting like here one of the catalysts you are using there. Next, if you are taking your contact process, So in this contact process, what is the catalyst you are using? Vanadium pentoxide, vanadium. So vanadium is behaving like one of the catalysts like that we are using there. So that means most of the transition elements are behaving like catalyst. Most of the D block elements, they behave like catalyst, like iron and vanadium, like that. Some of the element, most of the element, they're behaving like catalytic properties, right? So next one, see there, once NCERT what they're given. Next one, another one, if you're taking a hydrogenation process. So this hydrogenation process also, what metal we are using? Nickel metal we are using there. That means, so many of the D block elements and all what happen means, they're behaving like your catalytic properties. Catalyst like that, their behaving is takes place. So catalyst is nothing but what purpose you're using means, to increasing the rate of reaction, to speed up the rate of reaction. So reaction fast and nadakaradaka use panlonam, right? So that is called as your catalyst. So most of the transition element, they're behaving like catalytic property. Catalyst like that, it is behaving is takes place. Like some examples, what you're seeing, Haber process you are taking, counter process you are seeing there. Next, hydrogenation process. So like that, many of the reactions we are using the like this. Catalyst. So let us see that once where you're using that NCERT explanation part, we'll see that. Right. The transition metals and their compounds are known for their catalytic activity. So catalytic activity, what are the elements are especially we are using means mostly for D block element, that means transition elements. transition element, most of the elements we are using for this catalytic properties. This activity is ascribed to their ability to adapt multiple oxidation states and to form complexes. Multiple oxidation states is nothing but, for example, if you are taken manganese, you are taken. So it will show plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, and plus 7 also it will exhibit in there. So that means multiple is nothing but more than one oxidation state or more than two oxidation states is exhibiting means. That elements are called as multiple oxidation states, like that we are calling. Multiple, that means n number of oxidation states. So many of the oxidation states is exhibiting means. That is called as multiple oxidation states. So due to presence of this multiple oxidation states of elements, they will form complex compounds, will be forming this takes place. Complex compounds. So due to presence of your multiple oxidation states of the elements, it will form complex compounds, will be forming this takes place. Complex compounds is forming this takes place. So let us see that. So vanadium oxide is there. Vanadium oxide, that is called V2O5. Vanadium oxide, vanadium pentoxide we can say, or else we can call like vanadium oxide. So this vanadium oxide, where you are using contact process. Contact process we are using like catalyst, one of the catalysts. Next, finally divided iron. Iron is where you are using a Haber process we are using there. Haber's process, what is a catalyst you are using means iron. Iron is acting like one of the catalysts. Nickel is where you are using means catalytic hydrogenation process. Catalytic hydrogenation process, what you are using, element you are using, nickel and all we are using there. So that means vanadium, iron, nickel, these elements are belongs to here transition elements only. Transition elements are some of the examples for these catalytic reactions. Next one, see that. Catalyst at a solid surface involves the formation of bonds between the reactant molecules and atoms of the surface of the catalyst. So that means already we are seeing that intermediate compound formation. So surface chemistry, one topic is there. Surface chemistry, adsorption mechanism, one concept is there. So in that concept already we are clearly learning that. So for example, this is here surface is there. Surface and here catalyst will be presenting there. Catalyst and all what happened means it is very closely it will be presenting means. They have some attractive forces presenting there. So after some time what happened, the catalyst and all very close together means it will be bonding is takes place with the surface of this. Surface and all what happened, clearly it will be bonding is takes place. Right. So after this catalyst and all what happened, again it will be combining is takes place one and another. Two forms an intermediate complex will be forming there. Intermediate complex like this. For example, the A and B. So A and B. So first what happened? Catalyst and all here, first phase, first diagram, what is represent? Catalyst and here a surface and all far away distance will be there. Second phase, what happened mean? Catalyst and here a surface and all what happened? Very close together. Their bonding is takes place. Third phase, what happened mean? This catalyst and all what happened? More active sites and all here bonding is takes place. AB molecule will be forming there. Fourth stage, what happened means? A molecule and B molecule is a completely cleavage is takes place from away from the surface, AB molecule. So that means catalyst and all what happened me, active centers will be presenting there. So that active centers of this catalyst, easily bond forming this takes place with catalytic surface. So that means surface and all what happened, easily it will be bonding this formation is takes place, right? That only they say. So catalyst at a solid surface involves the formation of bonds between reactant molecules and atoms of the surface of the catalyst. So catalyst and all what happen? Easily bonding is takes place with the surface. So which element especially they are utilizing for this bond formation means? First row transition metals utilize 3D and 4S electrons for bonding. So 3D series elements and all especially what happen? They behaving like catalyst like that. Mostly the elements are behaving is takes place. And easily chemical bond formation, these 3D series elements and all what happen means easily they are acting like your catalytic surfaces will be presenting there. So that means more active sites of your catalytic surface will be presenting there. Right. Next one, see that. This has the effect of increasing the concentration of the reactants at the catalyst surface and also weakening of the bonds on the reacting molecules. So that means the activation energy is lowering. Also because the transition metal ions can change their oxidation states. So transition metals and what happen, their oxidation states also changing is takes place. They will become more effective as catalyst. For example, iron catalyzes the reaction between iodide and persulfate ions. So that means mostly these catalysts and all what happen means easily it will be catalyzing will be takes place. Catalyzing will be takes place and it will forms. Just a minute. Somebody's lobby room is there, I think. Just a minute. That's all okay. Fine. Right. So most of the elements and all what happen means increasing the concentration of the reactants at the catalyst surface. So catalytic surface and all what happen means mostly here more active site will be presenting there. More concentrations will be present on the surface of the catalyst. And also weakening the bonds in the reacting molecules. So reacting molecules and all what happen, I mean bonding and all it will be very weakening will be takes place. So also because of the transition metal ion can change their oxidation states. So that's why what happen oxidation state of these transition elements are what happen easily changing is takes place. Right. The next one, see that. So example, what you say me, for example, iodide ion is there. Iodide ion, for example, if you are react with the S2O8 molecule means to form iodide ion, what happen? It will be converting into iodine. Iodine marade, right? Persulfate ion and all what happen me easily it will be converting into sulfate ion, persulfate, S2O4. So S2O4 we can write, or else we can write SO4 twice also we can write. So persulfate will be converting into sulfate. SO4 ion will be forming is takes place. So in this what you are using means here, iron. Iron is also one of the catalysts like that, their behaving is takes place. So iodide ion what happened, if it is converting into iodine will be changing there, right? Next, persulfate ion, what happened? It will be converting into sulfate ion. It will be changing is takes place. This is another example for that. Next one, see that. Another explanation is given for catalytic action. Just see there. So Fe3+ ions while react with iodide ion means to form Fe2+ and iodine. So that means here reduction reaction is takes place. Reduction reaction. So Fe3+ will be converting into Fe2+. So decreasing of your positive charge. Decreasing of positive charge is nothing but reduction reaction. So Fe3+, what happened? It will be easily converting into Fe2+ while react with iodide ion. Iodide ion. So iodide ion and Fe3+ ions both are combining means it will forms Fe2+ ion and iodide molecule will be forming there. So that means simply what happened means reduction reaction will be takes place. Reduction reaction is takes place. So Fe3 plus will be converting into Fe2 plus. Reduction is happen. So here forming Fe2 plus ion for a further react with persulfate ion. S2O8 molecule further reacted means to become here Fe3 plus and sulfate ion will be forming there. Fe3 plus and sulfate ions will be forming. This takes place. So that means in that reactions, what you are finally concluding means, so catalytic surface and all what happen, more active concentrations will be presenting there. More active concentrations will be presenting is takes place. So that's why what happened that oxidation states will be changing is takes place. So initially what oxidation state they are forming Fe2 plus. Again, if it is react with a persulfate ion, if it is reacted means, again, it will be converting into sulfate ion MR. So that means oxidation states and all what happened means Fe2 plus will be converting into Fe3 plus. And Fe3 plus will be again converting into Fe2 plus. So that means exchanging of your oxidation state will be takes place. Exchanging of oxidation state will be takes place. So this is about here. So transition elements and all catalytic properties. Transition element, what are the catalytic properties they're exhibiting mean? These are the points. So that means due to presence of your catalytic surfaces, active sites, what happen means sometime their oxidation states also it will be differing. This takes place. That means increasing or decreasing also takes place. So this is about their catalytic properties. So simply how to remember two things. So many of the transition element, they behaving like catalytic surfaces. Why means, so many of the D block element they're act and they having here higher oxidation states is presenting there. And another one is more number of here unpaired electrons is presenting there. So due to because of these two things and all, most of the transition elements are behaving like. Most of the transition elements are behaving like catalyte, catalyst like that, their behaving is takes place. Right. So next one, see that. A very, very important next one also. So these three points also very, very important. So formation of interstitial compounds, alloys formation, catalytic properties, all these things are very, very important. So next one, see that formation of interstitial compounds. So do you remembering that or not interstitial compounds in solid state lesson? Anybody knows or not? Interstitial compounds, anybody knows?
Yes, sir.
What is that interstitial compounds? What is that?
Some small atoms are formed between the real atoms.
Yes, yes. Just look at here once. Interstitial sites is nothing but what you say. Yeah, yeah. I will tell you once. For example, especially interstitial compounds and which molecules are showing means, so AgBr, silver bromide and silver chloride, AgBr and AgCl, especially these two compounds and they're showing here, interstitial compound formations. So interstitial compounds is nothing but one of the element, it does not occupying their original position. So let us see that diagram once. Already we are discussing in solid state lesson. So silver bromide, you are taken for example, Ag plus and Br minus, Ag plus, Br minus, Br minus, Ag plus. Next, Br minus and Ag plus. Next, Ag plus, Br minus, here Ag plus, like that. So actually what happened next here, what will comes means second row, if you are taken, Br minus will comes here. Actual position is this one. But this Br minus and all what happened, they are forming interstitial. interstitial is nothing but in between some other, in between the two elements it is presenting, is takes place. So that site, what you call, means interstitial site, like that we are calling there. So that means actual position, that element and all, what happened, it does not occupying actual position, actual vacancy and all, what happened, that element is not occupying. So it will occupying in between the two elements, in between the two active sites of the elements is intersecting, is takes place, means that the compounds are called as interstitial compounds, like that we are calling there, interstitial compounds. That means actual position is one place, but unable to occupying that actual position, it will be presenting in some other place, some other location will be occupying, is takes place. So that is called as interstitial compounds, right? So mostly here D block element or a transition elements are why they are forming here interstitial compounds. Interstitial compounds, why transition elements are forming, this takes place, means. So let us see that there are some cases will be, some important points are there. So just all of you see that. Why D block, why transition elements, they're forming interstitial compounds. Let us see that. So interstitial compounds are those which are formed when small atoms like hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen are trapped inside the crystal lattice of metals. So the small atoms and all, what happened? Trapping. Trapping is nothing but trapping is takes place by these metals. So that means metals and all, what happen, easily these elements and all combining is takes place. Carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, these elements are what happen, easily it will be trapping. Trapping is nothing but easily combining is takes place. They are usually non-stoichiometric and are neither typical ionic nor covalent. So these elements, that means metals while react with these small elements like carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen is combining, means it may be forming like, it may be forming like ionic compounds will be forming, ionic compound may be forming, or else covalent compound will be forming, this takes place. Either ionic compounds is forming also takes place, or sometime it may be forming covalent compounds also forming, this takes place. For example, let us see that titanium, for sir, example. Sir. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, they are given neither ionic nor covalent, sir.
Yeah. Neither ionic nor covalent. Ionic nor covalent. So that means mostly it will forming either metal. Covalent compounds also forming, as well as ionic compound also forming there. For example, see there, how we are going to saying that whether it is a covalent compound or a ionic compound like that. For example, titanium carbide is there, titanium carbon. So titanium is metal and here carbon, what happened, non-metal is there, right? Next, manganese and nitrogen is there, Mn4 and nitrogen is there. So metal and non-metal is there. Next, Fe3H is there, iron hydride. Next, vanadium hydride is there, vanadium hydride. Next, titanium hydride will be presenting there. So that means ionic nor covalent will be presenting there, right? So that means mostly these transition metals are what happen, it will be small elements is combining, means ionic nor covalent compounds will be forming, this takes place, right? Next one, see that. Because of the nature of their composition, these compounds are referred to as interstitial compounds. So this element like a nor ionic or covalent compounds is forming, this takes place. So due to, because of their nature and their composition, these elements are called as interstitial compounds, like that you are referring, this takes place. So majorly these interstitial compound, what are the major characteristics are presenting, means there are some four characteristics will be presenting there. So what are the characteristics are presenting, means first one, see that. So these interstitial compounds are having higher melting points is present, higher melting points and higher than those of pure metals, higher than those of pure metals, compared to pure metals, higher melting points they are exhibiting. That is one of the point. Second point is, so these interstitial compounds are what happen means, very hard in nature, very hard in nature, very hard in nature. Some borides approaches diamond in hardness. So dimensional, what happened? Very hardest substance like that we are calling there. So why they are why they become here very hardness means, some borides are approach diamond in hardness. Boride compounds under what happened? Diamond inside is presenting there. So that's why what happened? Diamond will become very hardness in nature. Right, borides, some borides will be presenting, approach. Approaches is nothing but very close together. So due to because of some borides and all what happened, diamond is also become hardness. Next one, third one, see that. So these interstitial compounds are retain metallic conductivity. So metallic conductivity and all what happened, it will be retaining this takes place. Metallic conductivity also, it will be increasing this takes place. And they are chemically inert. They are stable. They are chemically inert. That means chemical reaction further, it won't be participating is takes place. Because they are chemically inert. They are stable. So their participation is very less in that chemical reactions. So these are very, very important characteristics. So sometimes they're asking this question also, why write the characteristics of your interstitial compounds like that. So simple things you have to remember. One is, so interstitial compounds are having higher melting points is presenting there. And compared to pure metals, they're exhibiting higher melting points. Second point is, they are very hard in nature. Interstitial compounds are very hard in nature. And interstitial compounds are contained here, metallic conductivity, retain their metallic conductivity. And fourth one is, they are chemically inert in nature. They are chemically inert. So these are the major characteristics of your interstitial compounds. So next one, see that alloys formation. So transition elements and how they are forming your alloy formation. So alloys, already we are learning in previous classes, what is mean by alloy. So it is made up of either metal to metal is presenting there, or metal and non-metal also combining is takes place. That is called as alloy. So a mixture of your metal and metal, or metal and non-metal, is called as alloys. So like a bronze and like this, and a silver like this you are taking there. So all these components and all what you call means here alloys. So that means different compositions of elements is presenting there. Either metal and metal, or metal and non-metal elements also presenting there. So these are called as alloys formation. So a mixture of different types of metal and metal, or metal and non-metal is combining means, that compounds are called alloys. So let us see that, how these transition elements, they're forming alloys formation. An alloy is a blend of metals prepared by mixing of the components. Alloys may be homogeneous solid solutions in which the atoms of one metal are distributed randomly among the atoms of the other. So that means metal and metal atoms and all what happen? One atom and all what happen? It is randomly, it will be distributing is takes place. Randomly is nothing but there is no regular manner, irregularity. Right. Alloys may be homogeneous solid solution. Homogeneous is nothing but unique. So it is completely what happened, same kind of particles only presenting there. That is called homogeneous solution like that. So this homogeneous solution particles are what happen means, atoms and all what happen means, so these atoms are randomly, they are distributed. Randomly is nothing but throughout this circle, the atoms are what happen in your randomly it will be circulating is takes place. So that means moving is takes place. Such alloys are formed by the atoms with metallic radii that are within about 15% of each other. So alloys formation, what happen means metallic radii that are within 15% of each other. So 15% each other, this metallic radii will be presenting for these transition elements. Right, next one, see that. Right, alloys so formed are hard and have often high melting points. The best known are ferrous alloys. Best known alloys, what do you call me? Ferrous alloys. So what are the other metals are presenting in that ferrous alloys means? Ferrous alloys, what are the metals is presenting means? There are chromium will be presenting there. Vanadium is presenting. Tungsten.
Sir, you are muted, sir.
Right. So that means most of these alloys, ferrous alloys, and what are the elements are presenting means? So ferrous alloys, most of the, what are the elements are presenting means? So there are chromium is present, vanadium is present, tungsten is presenting there, molybdenum also presenting, and a stainless steel also presenting there. So all these elements are present in that ferrous alloys, ferrous iron alloys. What are the elements are presenting mean? These are the elements is presenting there. Alloys of transition metals with non-transition metals such as brass, just now only I told brass, next bronze are the most alloys of your metals. So alloys, best example, what you call, what are the example means? Brass and bronze. So brass, what are the metals is presenting? Copper and zinc is presenting there. Copper and zinc. And bronze, what are the elements is presenting means? Copper and tin will be presenting there. Copper and tin is presenting there. Right. So brass, what are the elements is there? Copper and zinc is presenting there. These are important, right? These two words also important. Alloy, so examples are very, very important. Brass and bronze, what are the elements is present? What are the metals is presenting means? Brass metal is containing copper and zinc elements is presenting there. And the bronze is containing copper and tin. These two elements, metals are presenting there. So these are also called as your alloys, right? Alloys, best alloys. And next one, see that this is about your alloy formation. So that means most of these transition elements also, they're behaving like alloys formation. So what are the elements are presenting means? Like elements, vanadium is presenting there, copper is presenting there, tin is presenting there, zinc is presenting there, chromium is presenting there, vanadium is presenting there, tungsten will be present, molybdenum is present, iron is presenting, like that. So these elements are acting like here alloys. Alloys formation, these metals are especially, they are participating is takes place. So that means finally what you are concluding means, so mostly all the transition elements are, they are exhibiting colored compound formation, they are exhibiting. And mostly all the transition elements, they form here catalytic surface, catalytic properties they will exhibit. And next one, interstitial compounds will be forming, this takes place. And next one is alloys formation, mostly all the transition elements will be presenting there. And another one is, so complex compound formation, these transition elements are involving, this takes place, right? So these are the major elements uses. transition element, what are the major characteristics will be present in beams? First one is alloys formation. Mostly all the transition elements and all they are participating is takes place, and mostly all the transition elements are acting like your catalyst like that. Their behaving is takes place, and mostly transition element they're behaving like colored ions they're forming is takes place. And next one is mostly all transition element they forming interstitial compounds they're forming is takes place. And mostly all the transition element they will form complex compound formation. Mostly all transition elements are combining is takes place. So these are majorly characteristics of your transition elements, right? Next one see that example 8.0. let us see that. What is mean by disproportionation of an oxidation state? Give an example. Disproportionation is nothing but reactant side one of the element. After chemical reaction, what happen mean? Product side, it will exhibit different oxidation states is exhibiting means. That is called as a disproportionation reaction. So that means same one element, it will exhibit different oxidation states in product side means. That is called as disproportionation reaction. So the best example, see there once, manganese oxide is the best example for that. Let us see that equation part, all of you just see there. MnO4, manganese oxide while react with He plus ions means to form MnO4 minus ion is forming, and next one is MnO2 molecule will be forming there. So MnO2 is forming and another one MnO4 minus will be forming there. So here oxidation states and once observe, all of you once, MnO4 minus 2 ion. Here, what is oxidation state is exhibiting? Manganese means plus 4 is the oxidation state. In product side, what are the oxidation states is exhibiting? Means manganese here, it will shows 8 plus 8 oxidation state it will shows. Right. Here, what is the manganese? What is the oxidation state they're exhibiting? Means plus 6 oxidation state it will exhibit. Manganese, what is the oxidation state? Plus 6. And here, product side, if you are seeing, means manganese, what is the oxidation state they're exhibiting? Means so plus 7 oxidation state it will exhibit. And another manganese, it will show plus 4 oxidation state it will exhibiting is takes place. So that means element is same than a manganese is a reactant side, only one element is presenting there. So that same metal in product side, what happened? Different oxidation states is exhibiting is takes place, right? Same element can exhibit in two different oxidation states within the same reaction means. That reactions are called as disproportionation reactions. That means lower oxidation state is exhibiting, another one higher oxidation state also exhibiting means. That reactions are called as disproportionation reaction. So here what happened initially, a plus 6 oxidation state is the reactant side. But product side what happened here, 1 plus 7 oxidation state, higher oxidation state is exhibiting. And another one is lower oxidation state also exhibiting. So same element can exhibit lower and higher oxidation states within the same reaction means. That reactions are called as a disproportionation reactions. So let us see that once what they give an explanation part. Right. In a textbook, what they given, let us see that. solution part. When a particular oxidation state becomes less stable relative to other oxidation states, one lower and one higher, it is said to undergo disproportionation reaction. So that means initial what happened means here plus 6 oxidation state is presenting there. Particular oxidation state become less stable. Less stable is takes place. Relative to other oxidation state, one is plus 7 they are exhibiting, another one plus 4 oxidation state they are exhibiting there. That means lower and another one higher oxidation state is exhibiting. It is said to undergo disproportionation reaction. Same element, it will show one is higher oxidation state, another one lower oxidation state is exhibiting. That is called disproportionation reaction. So that is a answer for that example 8.0. Next one, see that. Some important compounds of your transition elements. Some important compounds of transition elements. So this is very, very important. Compounds and all very, very important. So potassium dichromate and another one, what you are saying, KMnO4, potassium permanganate, KMnO4. And another one is K2Cr2O7. So oxides of transition element. Transition element, what are the oxides will be forming means, especially many oxides will be there. So in compounds, what are the compounds they are forming means? Main important compound, what you are saying, these are the two important compounds of transition elements. One is, first one is potassium permanganate, and next one is potassium dichromate. So these two compounds, especially they are asking for 5-mark questions, and they are asking there. Explain the formation of your K2Cr2O7 compound, or explain the formation of KMnO4 solution, like that they will ask me. So especially here 5-mark and all these two compound preparation methods, structures also very, very important, right? So you have to must and shouldly have to practice it, this compound, two compounds also very, very important. Simple, but very, very, only three equations are there. KMnO4, three equations are there. K2Cr2O7 also three equations are there. So, but three equations also very, very important. Compulsory 5-mark question in the lesson K touch na maximum in the question over the wipe. And next one, oxidation reactions are there. How oxidizing is takes place and how reduction reactions is takes place. So redox reactions and all is there. So that also very, very important. Right. So just today we will see that one more concept, one compound I will explain, K2Cr2O7, only one compound we are seeing there. So tomorrow class we will see that remaining, potassium permanganate, KMnO4 compound tomorrow we are seeing there. Just only I will finishing up to this K2Cr2O7, only one compound I will explain, let us see that. So mostly all these D-block transition elements are what happen, oxides will be forming there. Oxides is nothing but one metal is reactive with one oxygen means, it will form here, oxides will be forming, this takes place. So which elements especially they are forming, mostly all the transition elements are easily they will forming, this takes place. Because oxygen is highly reacting, this takes place with the metal atoms. So metals are highly reacting, this takes place with oxygen means to form metal oxides will be forming, this takes place. So they given some oxides is given, let us see there after that, that oxides and this is nothing is there. So manganese, what are the oxides is present in there? Chromium, what are the oxides is forming there? Vanadium, what are the oxides is presenting there? The simple structure formulas is given. So that is later you can see there. So one metal is presenting there, one oxygen also presenting there. So what type of your oxides will be there mean? Depending upon the oxidation states of particular metals, different kind of your oxides will be forming. This takes place. Right, depending upon the oxidation state, different kind of your oxides will be forming. This takes place. In that, some of the oxides are what happened means there are three types is there. Acidic oxides will be there. Basic oxides will be there. And next one is amphoteric oxides also presenting there. Amphoteric. amphoteric oxides also present in this takes place. Acidic oxides, basic oxides, and amphoteric oxides. So sometime it will exhibit acidic and basic, mean that oxides are called as amphoteric oxides. Right? Acidic oxides in that metallic oxides, some oxides are exhibiting acidic nature, some oxides are acting like basic in nature, like that, their behaving is takes place. Right. Let us see that next one. Already they given some examples are given. Let us see there. Cr2O3 is acting like amphoteric oxide. CrO is acting like a basic oxide in nature. Like many of the oxides, they're exhibiting here acidic and as well as basic, like the vanadium oxide is a, for example. Vanadium oxide, they are acidic in nature. Vanadium oxide, chromic oxide, these are here acidic in nature. Next, manganese oxide, Mn2O7, they are covalent green oil. Covalent character they're exhibiting there. Like many of the oxides are what happen, mean three characteristics will be presenting there. Either acidic nature or basic nature, or sometime they shows amphoteric character also they're exhibiting is takes place. Right. So these are called as your oxides, oxides of your transition elements. Let us see that this compound, only one compound we are going to see. So next compound, tomorrow class we will see that. So this is very, very important. K2Cr2O7, K2Cr2O7, potassium dichromate, potassium dichromate. So this potassium dichromate, how we are going to preparing this compound means by using chromite ore. By using chromite ore, we are going to preparing here K2Cr2O7. So chromite ore is nothing but what you are calling means here. FeCr2O4, FeCr2O4 is called as chromite ore, chromite ore, chromite ore equal as. So by using this chromite ore, we are going to preparing here K2Cr2O7 compound, we are going to preparing there, potassium dichromate. Potassium dichromate, we are going to preparing this takes place by using chromite ore. So let us see that once what is happening there. So first what you are taken mean, chromite ore is taken. Chromite ore is nothing but FeCr2O4. So FeCr2O4 while react with sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, and oxygen, excess of oxygen is reacting means to form sodium sodium chromate will be forming Na2CrO4, Na2CrO4, sodium chromate will be forming there, and iron oxide Fe2O3 and carbon dioxide will be forming. So simply what happened means, here instead of your iron, here instead of your iron chromate, sodium metal here displacing this takes place, right? Iron place, what happens? Sodium is highly reactive metal. So that's why what happened? Easily displacing this takes place. Instead of iron, sodium metal will be occupying this takes place. Therefore, what happened? Sodium chromate will be forming there. Na2CrO4 will be forming there. Sodium chromate. So iron is here less reactive compared to sodium metal. So easily it will be displacing this takes place to form Na2CrO4 will be forming there. So here forming sodium chromate, again what happened means, it is react with excess of your acids. Excess of acid is reacting. H plus ion is nothing but acid. Either sulfuric acid we are taking or nitric acid we are taking there. Right. So here forming sodium chromate, Na2CrO4, is react with the sulfuric acid or H plus ion. Simply what you are, H plus. That means acid is reacting is takes place. So what happened means, sodium chromate will be converting into sodium dichromate. The sodium dichromate will be forming Na2CrO7. Plus 2 moles of sodium, Na plus ion will be lefting, and water molecule also lefting is takes place. Right? First step, what happened means, chromite ore you are taken, chromite ore react with the sodium carbonate and excess of oxygen means sodium chromate will be forming there, and iron oxide and water carbon dioxide is left it. So here forming sodium chromate further react with the sulfuric acid or nitric acid. Any acid medium is reacted means to form sodium dichromate, Na2Cr2O7. Sodium dichromate is forming. So here forming sodium dichromate further react with potassium chloride. Potassium chloride you are reacted means K2Cr2O7 plus 2 moles of sodium chloride will be left it. So finally what happened means instead of a sodium dichromate, if you react with KCl means, so potassium metal easily displacing a sodium metal, right? Sodium metal what happened? Replacement is taken. Sodium plus chlorine, both are combining me, NaCl will be left it. So instead of sodium, what metal is occupying means potassium metal is occupying this takes place. Therefore, K2Cr2O7 is forming plus NaCl compound will be left it there. Right. Simple equation. These three are very, very important. This is about your preparation of your sodium dichromate, potassium dichromate compound. First step, once again, see that chromite will react with sodium carbonate and oxygen means sodium chromate, iron oxide and carbon dioxide is forming. So here forming sodium chromate again react with the excess of your sulfuric acid. Any one acid medium reacted means sodium chromate will be converting into sodium dichromate. Sodium dichromate will be forming. So here forming sodium dichromate further react with the potassium chloride means, so potassium metal highly reactive compared to sodium. So easily it will be displacing this takes place to form potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7 plus NaCl will be left it. So this is the preparation of your potassium dichromate compound. Right, potassium dichromate compound formation. Next one, see that. Right. Next one, see there. Chromate ion structure and dichromate ion structures are given. Let us see that. Chromate is nothing but CrO3. CrO3 minus 2 is called chromate oxide, chromate ion. So this chromate ion, how we are writing this structure mean, chromium is a central atom. There are three oxygen, right, sorry. Chromate, CrO4 minus 2. CrO4 minus 2 is called chromate ion. Sodium chromate is Na2CrO4. Na2CrO4 is called sodium chromate, right. Chromate is nothing but CrO4 minus 2 ion is called chromate ion, right? So that means chromium is a central atom. There are four oxygen atoms are there. So three oxygen atoms here, lower level is presenting there. One oxygen atom here, upper level is presenting. So therefore, overall charge, what you are writing in, minus 2 is there. So that one you are supposed to write at the top. So this is about your chromate ion. So dichromate is nothing but how many is there? Two molecules is there, Cr2O7. Cr2O7 is called as a dichromate, Cr2O7 minus 2. Cr2O7 minus 2 is called dichromate. Potassium dichromate, K2Cr2O7. Sodium dichromate, Na2Cr2O7, like that. So dichromate is nothing but Cr2O7 minus 2 will be presenting there. So that is called a dichromate ion formation. So I think time is going to over. So tomorrow, once again, these preparations and these two compounds, once again, I will recapitulate. Very, very important. These equations, as it easily, you have to write. So there is no balancing also. Compulsorily, we have to do that. So without balancing also, that equations is not correct. So must and shouldly, everyone, you have to balancing that reactions as well as it easily.